Yasyabhavat bhaktajanati handugu prithamanyeshu avisharyadurnam Stambe vadara stamananya labhyam lakshmi nirzumam sharanam prabhatye Aho bile garuda shaila madhye kripa vasat kalpidasan nidhanam Lakshmiya samalingi devama baham lakshmi nirzumam sharanam prabhatye Srimade si lakshmi nirzumma parabrahmane namaham Asmat gurubhyo namaham Asmat sarvagurubhyo namaham Asmat Paramagurubhyo Namaha Keshavadya Kripa Patram Deshamadi Gunarnavam Shishadari Yadishanam Deshikendram Maham Bhaje Prabhatye Niravatyanam Nishadhyam Gunasambadam Sharanam Bhava Bhidhanam Shatakoba Munishwaram Srimadeshi Adivanchadago Vidindra Mahadeshikaya Namaha Sri Ranganatha Sadagopayadindra Dishtam Lakshmi Nrisimha Sadajit Karunaika Patram Sri Rangavida Raghurat Sadagopakrityam Vedanta Desika Yadindra Maham Prabhatye Srimade Sivan Sadagopay Sri Vedanta Desika Yadindra Mahadeshikaya Namaha Srimat Ranga Sadhari Samya Vivarat Labdagamandatvayam Srimat Vida Raghutvahatya Sadajit Padha Ravinda Shrayam Srimat Veda Vadam Sadesika Yadehe Karunya Vikshaspadam Sevedanga Durina Sasana Vasam Narayanam Yoginam Srimadesi Lakshmi Nrisimha Divya Paduka Sevaka Sivan Shadagopa Sri Narayana Yadindra Mahadeshikaya Namaha Vedanta Desika Yadindra Kadakshalabda Trayanta Sara Manavatya Gunam Budhagriyam Narayanate Yadi Durya Kripa Prashiktam Sri Ranganatha Yadi Sekara Mashriyamakam Srimade Sivan Sharagopa Sri Ranganatha Yadindra Mahadeshikaya Namaha Yo Nitya Machyuta Padham Bhuja Yugma Rukma Vyamoha Dastadi Dharani Trinaya Mene Asmat Guror Bhagavato Sideka Sindhoho Ramanujasya Charanau Sharanam Prabhatye Tasmai Ramanujaryaya Nama Paramayogine Yasrudi Smriti Sutranam Andar Jwaram Ashishamadi Pranamam Lakshmana Muni Pradikrishnadu Mamakam Prasada Yadi Yat Suktihi Swadhina Padikham Shrudim Shriman Venkatanathariyam Kavidharki Kekesari Vedhanta Acharya Varyome Sannidhattam Sadakhrithi Jnanandamayam Devam Nirmalaspatikakrithim Adharam Sarvavidhyanam Hayagreevam Upasmahe Gurubhyah Tad Gurubhyasya Namo Vakamadimahe Vrinimagecha Tatradhyav Dampati Chakadampati Ullasa Pallavida Palika Saptalogi Nirvaga Goragidane Makadakshalilam Sriranga Harmyadala Mangala Dibaregam Sriranga Raja Magishim Shrayama Shrayamaka Praya Prabhadane Pumsam Pauna Punyam Nivarayan Astra Sriranga Bhartutmam Avyat Abhayamudridaha Agilabona Janmaste Mabangadilile Vinade Vivida Budhau Radha Rakshay Gadikshe Sudhisirasi Vidipte Brahmane Srinivase Bhavad Mama Parasmin Semushi Bhakti Rupa Parasharya Vachasudam Upanishat Duktabdi Madhyo Durdam Samsara Agni Vidhi Bhanabhyabhagada Pranatma Sanjeevanim Purvacharya Surakshidam Bhagumadi Vyagada Durastidam Anitam Tanichakshray Sumanaso Baumadivan Dvandvaham. We are enjoying Śrībhāṣyam, Embaramanar, Bhagavad Bhashyakarar, Bhagavad Ramanujar's explanation of Brahma Sutram in the Tattvatrayam concept, Chit, Achit, Iswaran, three different entities. So based on that one, we are enjoying, this is the magnum opus, we are looking at the fourth adhyaya, Phalādhyāya, fourth pādam, Mukti pādam, Moksha palan. This is the 81st lecture and this will be the last lecture. We will be concluding on this. But anytime when we conclude, this sequence is over, we will be starting something else in the middle. But for now, this will be the last session on that one. What is the palan for the Brahma Jnani? One who has completed 31 Brahma Vidyas, all you have to do only one of them. Even though there are 31 Brahma Vidyas are there, only one. Similarly, the Nyasa Vidya, Prabhati, Sharanagadi, Adakkalam, Paranyasam, Barasamarpanam, Atvanikshebam, whatever we call, you do that one. The Palan, what they are going to get, when this Atma is put into the Sukshma Sariram, pushing through the Brahmanadi, coming through the Uchandalai, what is called as a Murdhanyanadi, going through the Archiradi Margam, crossing the Viraja River, Amanavan Sparasam, all of them will be the same. The Ubhayam part will be different, the Palan will be the same. Tulya Vikalpam, that is what Swami Desikan calls in Ragasatra Saram, equivalent, alternate ways, two different ways you go, but the destination is the same. So, that is what you will go to the Moksham, you will go to the Paramapadam, that is the only once you will go. Because crossing this Viraja River only once, because we've been all the time like a fish in the bowl, going through the Samsara Sagaram again and again and again. So, you have the Janma and the Maranam, then the Janma and the Maranam. So, again and again we do that one. So, to get released only once you have to do that. So, when you do that one, is there any chance you may come back over here? That is what we are looking for. So, when we looked at that one for so many different ways, Embirumanar was showing that there is no necessity for him to come back and he will not come back. He will not come back means based on the karma, based on the samsaram and everything. There is no binding one. Bhagavan can command you to go down and do something and come back. Other than that, karma will not force you to do that one. So the moksha palan, that is what we are discussing on the fourth padam. The last Brahma Sutram is Anavrit Deshabdad, Anavrit Deshabdad. Vedas claim he does not return. What it means, Muktan is a one-way path. We said there are two places, Paramapadam and here Leela Vibhudi. Leela Vibhudi, Nitya Vibhudi. Take those two places. So there are four possibilities are there. People who are here itself, that is called Baddha Jiva. They are samsaris. People who are in the Nitya Vibhuti all the time, they are all the Nitya Suris. So, and then two of them, and one goes from here to there. That is the third one. That is the Muktas. They go from here to the Moksham. What is the last alternate? People coming from the Paramapadam to Bhulogam, Paramapadam to Leela Vibhuti, that doesn't happen. So, only three possibilities are there. The fourth possibility does not exist. That is what it's told over here. So, Muktan, when we completed the Bhakti Yogam successfully or the Prabhati successfully, will not return to the Karma Bhumi. No karma, no janma, no birth-death cycle associated with him. That's what we're doing. Embirumanar explains to him very beautifully, says, so, forcefully, is there anybody else would send him? Nobody would be. Bhagavan, who conferred the moksha for him, is all-powerful and he will not send him because he has been longing, he has been craving for this Muktan to come. For this Baddha Jeevan, he was waiting for which day he is going to do the Sharanagadi or Bhakti Yogam to come here. So, Bhagavan has got all the wealth and we are not interested in that one. We are having the Bhogyam in the Bhulogam. All of them are Alpa Astara Palan. Only when you realize that Jnanam, then you do some kind of a Ubhayam, then you go to the Moksham, Bhagavan is waiting for that. When he has been waiting for trillions of Janmas, trillions of Yugas, trillions of Srishti, Sthiti, Samharam cycle, finally you go over here, would you send him back? He will never send you back over here. And understand, all the Srishti, Sthiti, Samharam is below the Viraja River only. Nitya Vibhuti, as it states, there is no Srishti there is no Sthiti, or there is no Samharam. It is permanently staying over there. We cannot say it started, it is running, and then it is ending. It's been there forever. So, Bhagavan will not send him. Second, Muktan, on his own accord, on his own wish, would he come back now? Why should you? You done all these kinds of things to go and you are longing, desperate for that one. When you get a chance, it is like $1 trillion lottery ticket you got. Just making a simple example, why you want to give that one and go? So, you are associated eternally with the great gunas abhagada bapma vijaro vimrityugu vishoga vijigatsa abhivasa satyakama satyasangalpa. As it says the Chantokya Upanishad, you are going to get all of them. Then what is the necessity for you to come back? So third one is anybody else would do. Nobody else has got the power. Nobody else can overrule Bhagavan. So Muktan will not come. In that aspect, Emperuman are beautifully explaining three Bhagavad Gita slogas at the end. Totally five slogas are there. Three slogas is explaining. On the third one we are looking. Bahunam janmanamante jnanavanman prabhatyade vasudeva sarvamidi sa mahatma sudurlabha. If you take Bhagavad Gita, only two words that tells everything. Vasudeva sarvam. That's all it is. The whole Bhagavad Gita essence is Vasudeva sarvam. Not only Bhagavad Gita, all the Upanishad saram Vasudeva sarvam. Not Upanishad alone, take the whole Vedas, which are the Karma Yogam and everything, explaining all those kind of a thing. Purva Mimamsa also, everything Vasudeva Sarvam. That is the essence we have to understand. Either you are doing a Bhakti Yogam or Prabhati Yogam. So that can be explained so nicely by so many acharyas, so many different ways and everything. Emperuman are explaining over here. Bhagavat Ramanuja says for this sloga, what is the ultimate achievement for a Jeevatma? We are all here and we don't know how many births we had and everything. In today there may be one achievement, in this life may be one achievement. But after so many trillions of janmas, what you are going to achieve? The ultimate achievement after infinite good births, not ordinary birth, good births, some of them, is finally to take the refuge at the Lord Krishna's lotus feet. That is the biggest achievement we can make. After passing through countless janmas, one obtains that knowledge, that insight, some awakening over there, realization, understanding. What is that realization? Very beautifully, Emperumana says, we are going to break that one down, very similar to the Prabhati Yogam, where five angas, sixth one is the angi. Similar to that one, that jnanam we are breaking in the same way. First one, the ultimate joy. What would make you the maximum happy? That happiness never reduces. That happiness never ends. And that happiness cannot be more than anything else. This is the highest one. That's what you got. So what is the ultimate joy? Ultimate joy is understanding you. What do you understand? What do you mean by understanding you? We have an Atma and a Shariram. Shariram is going to go, it is going to be burnt. This Atma has got a knowledge. That knowledge is the Dharmi Jnanam, which is substantial knowledge for the Atma. It says, me, 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 and I am a servant to the Bhagavan. Me, 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 we realize many times, no problem at all. Is there any time you get confused? Am I the, Nandana, Tamil Sulacha? Am I the person, same thing what I see? So you never get doubt. You understand who you are. So, but the real who is this Surubam. I am the Seshan. I am the slave. I am the servant. Agaram. Agaratla irukkakudiyadana lupta chadurthi and ugaram and then magaram. Magaram is the jeevan, agaram is the Bhagavan. The lupta chadurthi says Bhagavan is the boss, you are the slave. And ugaram says exclusively. So that is the pranamam's meaning very simplistically. So we get the Swaroopa Vikasam. What is the Swaroopa Vikasam? Sheer dependence ultimately with the Lord. That is with the Krishna. Okay, that is the first one. The joy for you, not the jalebi, not the puliyodarai, not sitting in the AC room, not having all those kinds of luxuries and everything, none of them. Your Atma craves It wants to serve the Bhagavan. And only when you satisfy that one, you are finally accomplishing the ultimate joy. Understand that one first. Second one. The Jivatma saying, Swarupa, Sthiti, Pravritti. Three of them are there. Your Swarupa means basically the essence what you are. And Sthiti means continued existence of that. Pravritti means activities. Your essence and continued existence and the activities are completely under his control. You may get a little freedom. That freedom is also given by him. Okay. So you have to understand, Jivan, Bhagavan gives us some kind of a freedom. With that freedom only we do. So my Swarupa, Sthiti, Pravritti, all of them under his control. Third one. He is superior, bar none. Nobody above him, nobody equal to him. Ottar mikkarai ilayaya mamayam. As an Ammalvar says, nobody ottar, nobody mikkar. Nobody equal, nobody above him. Okay. So, he is the Lord Supreme. Fourth one. He has got innumerable Trikalyana Gunas, auspicious qualities. That is the fourth one. Fifth one, understanding these four, I come to the conclusion, Vasudeva is my highest goal. To attain that Lord Sriman Narayana, Vasudeva, Krishna, to attain him, that is the highest goal today in this Janma. Millions of Janma I have crossed. That's what I have to do. To attain that goal is the means. So, we have to understand the goal and the means. That's why we say gadi. When you say gadi, the path in which you go, that is ubayam, and the final destination you get, both of them is the same. So, fifth one, understanding, Vasudeva alone. He alone is my highest goal and also the ubayam to attain that kind of a ubayam. Understanding these five. Ultimate joy, what is your swarupam based? My swarupa sthiti pravritti, all of them under his control. He is the superior, nobody else is above him or equal to him. Fourth one, he has got innumerable Tirukalyana gunas. Fifth one, I understand based on all of them, Vasudeva, you are the means, you are the rewards. Ubayam and Ubayam, both of them is the same. After realizing all of them, you don't have no other choice. You go and hold on to the Bhagavan's lotus feet, takes the refuge. You start meditating on him. In the Śrībhāṣyam, meditation. In the Śaraṇāgati Gatyam, you do the Śaraṇāgati or a Prabhatti on that. So these are the six things Emperumanar very beautifully puts over here in Gita Bhashyam. Explaining the Bahunam Janmanamante Jnanavanman Prabhatyade. After so many trillions of Janmas, you get the Jnanam. What kind of a Jnanam? This is the Jnanam you get. That is what it says. All the five and the sixth one, you do the Ubayam for that. Here, Emperumanar, when he says, very beautifully he points out, there is no Swarupa Aikyam. The principle that says identity of the individual Atma and the Brahman is the same. That is refuted. That is refused. That is discarded. That is proven wrong. Brahma, Jivatma, Aikyam, one and the same is wrong. That is what the Advaitam says. That is wrong. So when you say, I want to go to the moksham, I want to go to that place, Bhagavan gives that one, he is always the boss and everything, he is the boss for all of them and everything, there are two entities separate. Actually, there are three entities that are separate, Tattvatrayam, Chit, Achit, Ishwaran. Achit, Achetana Tattvam, which are non-sentient, which don't have any Atma, which don't have any Buddhi, which don't have any Swabhavam, That is the Achit. Chit means it's in knowledge. You have Swarupam and Swabhavam and everything. Swabhavam changes with respect to the DBJ. Swarupam is always consistent with the DJ, Dharmi Jnanam. And then the highest Chetanan, which is the Bhagavan, Ishwaran, is the only one. So this Chetanas, instead of looking at the Achetana Vastu, you should be looking at the Bhagavan. Instead of looking at a la carte, one by one getting all this palan, you go and get Bhagavan, you got everything. So that is what it says. So, finally what you understand, that giver and the taker are different. They cannot be the same. And your Atma says, I want to do Kaikaryam. That means you do Kaikaryam for a different person. That is why in Tirupavi, when you look at that one, Uravu, that is the word, relation. And I'll always put that one, Uravu, Abhrudak Siddhi, when you say it in the Ragasatra Saram, which cannot be removed, which cannot be refuted. It is always there, which cannot be separated, inseparable. The Jivatma-Paramatma relation is like the Shariram and the Atma-Bhavam. That is what? It cannot be Nee-Indri Naan-Illai, Naan-Indri Nee-Illai, as Alvar says that one. So, Brahmam and Jivatma is the same when Advaitam says that is not possible in the Visishta Advaitam. Specialize the case of that one. We are the Sariram for the Bhagavan. That's what we are understanding. Vasudeva alone is the highest goal and the means. Okay? That is the only possible meaning, Embirumanar said. Vasudeva is all. Vasudeva sarvam idi. When he says sarvam idi, that means Bhagavan alone is everything. So when you say everything, very beautifully we can explain with the Bhagavad Gita, so many slogans are there. So here when we say Vasudeva is everything, we are part of that one. We are part of that one in the sense we are the Sariram is the Atma. When you are containing your Atma and his Atma, those two are different. But both your Atma and your body, both of them form a Sariram to Bhagavan. So one way you are along with the Bhagavan, the other way, you are different from the. That is why Visishta Advaitam. Vasudeva Sarvamidi. It does not say, I am the Sarvam. Jivatma will not say that one. That is not being told here. You hold on to him. That means you and him are different. He supports, controls, and owns you. You are supported, controlled, and owned you. That means two different things. He is the means, he is the rewards. That means you are asking and he is giving. You are requesting and he is conferring. So when you look at that one, these two are different, and Embirumanar wants to make sure people understand by going to the moksham, there is no Swarupa Aikyam. Even in moksham, Bhagavan is different, you are different. You will never become Bhagavan. Now, let's go back into the three slogas what we saw, Embirumanar bringing that one. We started with the statement, the first sloga said, Tesham jnani nitya yukta yega bhaktir visishyade priyohi jnani notyartam aham sacha mama priyaha. Second line, priyohi jnani naha atyartam aham sacha mama priyaha. The jnani loves me extremely. He cannot stay without me. For him, I am the ultimate. Likewise, I am dear to him. When you do so much, Patthudai adiyavar kaliyavan, pirargalak kariyavittahan, Namalvar, Samaveda, Shantokya Upanishad, Saram, he puts, Patthudai adiyavar kaliyavan, if you go towards the Bhagavan 1 feet, he comes million steps closer to you from his side. So, Patthudai adiyavarkku eliyavan is so saulabhyam, so simple and everything. Pirargalakku ariyavittagan, all other people, those who are not devotees, those who are not bhaktas, they cannot understand him. So, he says here, I am very dear to him. That is the most important over here. And the second sloga when he says, Udhara sarvaye vaide ஞானீத்து ஆத்மைவ மேமதம் ஆஸ்திர சகி யுக்தாத்மா மாமேவாம் மனுத்தமாம் கதிம். திஸ் யுக்தாத்மா இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் வாண்டட் விட் பி தி பகவான் ஹவு நித்தியயுக்தா ஏக பக்திர். தி ப்ரீவியஸ் ஸ்லோகா சேஸ் ஆல் தி டைம் வாண்டட் டு பி அசோசியேட்டட் ஒன்லி வித் மீ. தட் பர்சன் மா ஏவ அனுத்தமாம் கதிம். தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். மீ அண்ட் மீ ஒன்லி, அட் இஸ் தி ஹையஸ்ட் உபாயம், ஹையஸ்ட் பலன், வித்தவுட் எனி திங் எல்ஸ் கன்சிடரிங். ஸோ சர்வதர்மான் பரித்யச்ச, வென் இட் கோஸ் இன் டு தி கீதை இன் தி 1866, இஸ் அனுத்தமாம் கதிம், சி தி ஹையஸ்ட், இன்கம்பேரபிளி, தட் இஸ் தி பெஸ்ட், அன்சர்பேஸ்ட். ஆஸ்திதக மீன்ஸ் யூ ஆர் அண்டர்டேக்கன், மவுண்டட், பிராட், கேரிட், ஸ்டெபிளைஸ்ட். ஸோ வித் தீஸ் டூ, வென் யூ டூ தட் ஒன், தென் வாட் வி ஆர் சேயிங் இன் தி உத்தவ கீதா, சேம் திங் கிருஷ்ணா டெல்ஸ் இன் எ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் வே. தும் து சர்வம் பரித்யச்ச ஸ்நேகம் ஸ்வஜன பந்துஷு மையா வேஷ்ய மன சம்யக். சர்வம் பரித்யச்ச, யூ ஹவ் கிவன் அப் ஆல் தி டிஃப்ரெண்ட் அச்சேதன வஸ்து. ஸ்நேகம் ஸ்வஜன பந்துஷு, யுவர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், யுவர் கம்யூனிட்டி, யுவர் குரூப் அண்ட் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் அண்ட் ரிலேட்டிவ்ஸ், ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் கிவ் அப். மயி ஆவேஷ மன சம்யக்கு, இன்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் டேர்னிங் ஏ சேதனா, இன்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் டேர்னிங் யுவர் மைண்ட் இன் டு தி அச்சேதன வஸ்து, டேர்ன் டுவோர்ட்ஸ் பகவான். தட் இஸ் வாட் தி அம்சகீதா இஸ் ஆல்சோ சேயிங். ஸோ திஸ் கன்க்ளூஷன் வாட் வி ஆர் சேயிங், ஞானி, ஞானி மீன்ஸ் என்லைட்டட் ஒன், தி ஞானம் யூ காட் தட், ஸோ தி ஸ்வரூப விகாசம் யூ காட் தட் ஒன், தென் யூ கெட் தி ஸ்பெஷலைஸ்ட் குவாலிட்டிஸ். வென் யூ கெட் தி ஸ்பெஷலைஸ்ட் குவாலிட்டிஸ் அண்ட் தட் ஞானி wants to grab that kind of a happiness, what he is going to feel, that is why he does the Ubayam Bhakti Yogam for that one. Jnani means he understand things correctly as it is. That is what he says. I am going to defer this one. We can go into the Bhagavad Gita. This is the sloka what we are talking about, 7-18. And go through 1-17, very beautifully Krishna explains why, what is the jnani, what you have to understand. So that's the one, separately we can take it, not in the Śrībhāṣyam here, separately we do, very beautiful one. Vasudeva sarvam, how do you come to that conclusion? So that is what, up to the first 6 chapters Krishna is explaining, at the end you say, hey, you do the bhakti to me, understand me, he says and concludes. Then the 7th chapter beginning is asking, Krishna, understanding you means what? How do you understand you? What I need to understand? Then Krishna tries to explain, who am I? And then all the kinds of things, 16 slogas is explained. Then he is coming to the 7th one. That is how you come to the conclusion, Vasudeva Sarvamidhi. So that's the, from the Bhagavad Gita viewpoint, that is from the Bhakti Yogam. Let's stop and take in a parallel over here. When you go to the Sharanagati Gatyam, see, both of them are very similar, okay? One of Bhakti Yogam and Prabhati Yogam is exactly the same. In the Bhakti Yogam, you do that. In the Prabhati Yogam, you say, I cannot do that. Bhagavan, you think that I have done. You stand in that place, give me the reward. All others are the same. Okay? So, when you come over here and the Prabhati, I am picking it from the middle of the Gadyatrayam, in the Shanagadi Gatyam, if you look at that one. Madhyanadi karma prabhagavrittam bhagavat surubha dirodhanagarim விபரீத ஜான ஜனனீம் ஸ்வவிஷயாஸ்ய போக்ய புத்தே ஜனனீம் தேகேந்திரியத்வேன போக்யத்வேன சூக்ஷ்ம ரூபேன ச அவஸ்திதாம் தெய்வீம் குணமயீம் மாயாம் தாசபூதஹ சரணாகதோஸ்மி தவாஸ்மி தாசஹ இதி வக்தாரம் மாம் தாரய. வெரி பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி. தி ரீசன் ஐ பிக் தட் ஒன், the three slogans we are discussing here, same thing is repeated there. Emperumanar gives a clue over here, try to show the Bhakti Yogam in one side, Prabhati Yogam in the Gadhyam, both of them are same means, same rewards. Okay? One, you are praying the Bhagavan, give me the strength, I will walk. The other one we tell, I am a baby, I cannot walk, Bhagavan, you carry me. That's all it is. So, when you look here, what all of them applies, because in the Gadhyam, whatever we say, this is the same thing is going to apply, up to this one is going to apply for the Bhakti Yogam also. Later on, Bhagavan is going to ask, then he says, I don't have any of these things, he's going to tell after this one. Here, Madhyanadi karma prabhagavrittam. Madhya, because of me. Oh, Bhagavan thinks, oh, this person, I have to give him all the sin, I have to put him down. He never does that one. He is like a judge. He looks at everything equally and tries to do correctly. He doesn't want to dump all the bad things to you. Bhagavan is not sitting over there and take the vengeance, I want to punish him. No, it is not. What you do is coming back to you. Madhya, because of me, not because of you or not because of somebody. Anadi karma pravaga vrittam. Countless days, ageless, beginningless, it is coming. Karma pravagam. It is like a floods. Vrittam continued to coming on that one. What it does? Bhagavat Swaroopa Dhirodhana Kareem. Bhagavat Swaroopa Dhirodhana. Dhirodhana means covering, concealing, and curtailing that one. So, Bhagavat Swaroopam, you don't understand. Why? Because of your karma. That's the same for Bhakti Yogam or Prabhati Yogam. Okay. So, here when you talk about Bhakti Yogam, you have to start thinking about Bhagavanudaya Swaroopam, Divya Mangala. So, Divyatma Swaroopam, Divya Mangala Vigraham in the Prabhati, Divyatma Swaroopam, when you think about it. So, out of 31 Brahma Vidyas, you have to go and look at the Bhagavan Swaroopam in any one of them. Sadvidya, Dagara Vidya, Madhi Vidya, Sandilya Vidya. So many 31 Vidyas are there. 15 of them told in the Chantokya Upanishad. You go through one of those things. To do that one, you have to understand Bhagavan's Swaroopam. Bhagavat Swaroopa Dhirodhana Kareem. It is not showing. We want to go to the temple. Want to have a wonderful, beautiful Archavadaram, Parthasarathi Perumal or Thiruvengada Mudiyanar, Oppliyappan, we want to have the darshan. When you go there, they put a screen. You are standing here with all the eagerness. Bhagavan is standing there, he wants to give. In between, there is a screen there. And the small screen, if you remove, you get everything. And that is what's happening to me. What is that small screen? For Bhagavan, he can make it small. For us, it's so huge because Madhyanadi karma pravagavrittam Bhagavat Swaroopa Dhirodhanagarim Vibarida Jnana Jananeem. What happens? Without understanding Bhagavan's Swaroopam, our janmas, our karmas, all our papa punyangal and everything pushes me into creating Vibarida Jnanam. Why do we have to go to the temple? Why we have to read Bhagavad Gita? Why we have to go to the Upanyasam? Let's go to the movie. Let's go and enjoy this one. So you divert. So Viparita Jnanam. Why? Of course. Atmanam radinam vidya shariram radam evadhu. As the Kadopanishad says, the buddhi is telling something. The manasi goes in a different way. So you move on the other way. Instead of going towards the Ishwaran, you go towards the Achetana. Bhogyam. So, Viparita Jnana Jananim. So, Viparita Jnanam. Forget about the temple, forget about all of them. Let's go and enjoy this one. So, you start enjoying the Alpa Astira Palan. Adha, so, Sva Vishayascha Bhogya Buddhe Jananim. Sva Vishayascha. What it will do, it will try to give, is a happiness for me. That is what? Dharma Buddhi Jnanam is telling, your indriyams are telling, so you want to enjoy that one. So you shut out the Dharmi Jnanam as a curtain and then you go, Sa Vishayascha Bhogya Buddhi, the Buddhi goes into the Bhogyam, that is being created, Janani. Dehendriyatvena, Bhogyatvena, Sukshma Rubena Chavasthidam. The Sukshma Rubam, what happens is, from the Prakriti, Magathu, Agangaram, Panja Tanmatrai, Panja Karmendriyam, Panja Jnanendriyam, Manasu, all the Achetana Tattvam put together, that is the one there, Dehendriyatvena. So, Deham and Indriyam, all of them, that wants to the Bhogyam. What is good? See, very simple, if you are looking at that one, in the real life example, what is good for your tongue? The food that is not good for your health. Very simple. Most of the time, what you eat, sugar, is so good, you get diabetes. And this is very nice. And all the roasted stuff, you take that one, then fat is gone. So anything that tastes on the tongue, that is not good for the health. Similarly, anything that is good for this body, anything that good for the indriyam, that is not good for the atma. That is why all the rishis, what they do, they did the tapas and everything. Look at their body and all of them, because they don't want to feed the indriyams. Instead of, they want to feed the atma. Atma's jivanam is based on only nama uchharanam. Narayana, Narayana, it wants to say. Aalvark, finally, Priyalvar Spasuram, we're going to take. So, it wants to do that Bhagavata nama uchharanam. So, Madhyanadi karma pravagavrattam bhagavat swarupa dirodhanagarim vibarida jnana janinim so vishayacha bhogya buddhe janinim dehendriyatvena bhogyatvena sukshurivena chavasidam daivim. I am here in a leela vibhuti as a leelobhagaranam for you. I am just a toy. You are playing with that. That is what I am here. So, daivim gunamayim mayam, you have created the trigunas, prakriti, magathu, agangaram. When you come over here, there are three gunas, sattva, rajasa, tamasa gunas. Three pistons are going up and down. I am not completely on the sattva gunam. That is the reason I am doing all them. Ajnanam, karma, vasanai, ruji, dega sambandham. That cycle is coming based on ajnanam. That ajnanam comes because of what I am associated with, the rajogunam and tamogunam. Why I am associated with rajogunam and tamogunam? Because that is what the Dharma Buddha jnanam I have given when I was birth. Why I was given that one? Because madhyanadi karma pravagavrittam, boxes and boxes of all the bad things we have done. And we have to exhaust that one. Daivim gunamayim mayam dasabudaha. With all these things, I understand, I am a servant to you. Nobody denies that one. See, if you are basically a astigan, we understand Bhagavan is great. We understand going to temple is good. We understand telling slogans are good. Listening to Upanyasam is good. But we don't do that. Understanding is one of them. Doing is another thing. We have to execute. That is one of the reasons why Swami Desikan in Ragasetra Saram says, don't keep on going for the Jnana Sambadhyam. There is no reason for that. The only time you need a Jnana Sambadhyam is when you are going to do the kind of Kaikaryam, Bhagavad Bhavada Kaikaryam, without any flaws. If it can help that one, then you do. Other than that, there is no necessity for that. Whatever I have to know, I already learnt in my second grade. That is one of the book. Irma Bampak, one person has written, you already learnt everything. But we are very lazy. And we don't want to do the execution part. So we want to keep on learning. If you keep on studying, when you going to go to work and make money? The reason why you are studying is go to work. Similarly, the reason why you are studying all the Vedas and all the Upanyasam listening, to do the work. What is the work? Kaikaryam. Bhagavad Bhagavata Kaikaryam. That is what it is. So, Gunamayim Dasabudaha Sharanagadosmi Tavasmi Dasaha Tava Asmi Dasaha Iri Bhaktaram. That's how I am telling. Mam Taraya Taraya Tarayadi means save me, rescue, liberate. That is what he is asking. I am into this kind of a janmas and everything. Why? I have listed because of that viparita jnanam pushes more into deha, indriya, bhogyam and everything. So please release me from that. Why? Because I am your servant. And I am saying sharanagati. And I am saying tava asmi dasaha. I am the dasan for you. Idi bhaktaram mam taraya. Now the three slogas what we saw in the end of Śrībhāṣyam is repeated. Same Bhagavad Gita sloga. That is where the congruence between that one and this, whether you are doing a bhakti yogam or prabhati yogam, these three slogas are very, very important Emperumanar things. Tesham jnani nitya yuktaha ekabhattir visishyate priyogi jnani notyartam agham secha mama priyaha udhara sarve evaide jnani tu atmaiva me madam astira sagi yuktatma mamevam nuttamam gadim bahunam janmanamante jnanavanman prabhatyate vasudeva sarvamidi samahatma sudurlabha. It is slogatrayadi jnaninam mam kurushvam. ఇది శ్లోకత్రయ ఇది జ్ఞానం జ్ఞానినం మాం కురుష్వ. హాస్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ దిస్ దీస్ శ్లోకాస్ ఈస్ ఆస్కింగ్ టు కృష్ణ. ఓకే, మేక్ మీ టు గివ్ దట్ వన్. ఈస్ ఆస్కింగ్ యూ టోల్డ్ హియర్ సో మెనీ థింగ్ నిత్యయుక్తగా ఏకభక్తి మామేవా అనుత్తమాం గదిం వాసుదేవ సర్వం. హౌ డు ఐ గెట్ దట్ వన్? ప్లీజ్ బ్లెస్ మీ టు గెట్ దట్ నాలెడ్జ్. That is what he is asking here. So, what is that knowledge? Parabhakti parajnana paramabhakti ega swabhavam mam kurushva. Continues next one. Parabhakti parajnana paramabhakti. That is how you go into the bhakti yoga. See, this is all these things explained over here is applicable to the bhakti yoga. Then Bhagavan is asking, if I give, why you are not doing? Then he says, I cannot do any of them because my karmas are so bad. It is all you have to do, remove all those things, write off all of them, erase everything. That is what he is going to ask that one. Then he says, so dvaya mantram and go into the sharanagati route. But up to this one, when you come, it is the same thing, common stumbling block. Virodhi sorubam for bhakti yogi or prabhannan is exactly the same. That is what he is bringing over here. So, we need to go back to understand all these things in the, as I said, in the 7th chapter, very beautifully Krishna is explaining. We will take it in a different class. I didn't want to conclude the Śrībhāṣyam here. So we'll take separately, you know, as a random lectures or somewhere, we'll take that one. So Emperumanar continues, Idi sutrabhyasaha sastra parisamaptim dhuyo dayadi idi sarvam samanchasam. He says, idi sutrabhyasaha sastra parisamaptin. So in this way, dhyoyodayadi, when he says that two times it is told, what is that? Anavriddhi shabdad, anavriddhi shabdad. That 545th sutra, the last one in the, Brahma Sutra, last one, he says, never returns, never returns. That is what Vedas proclaim. The reason for the repetition, Emperumanar says, indicates the sastras are complete. Thus, all the interpretation indicates the muktan who has gone to the paramapadam will not return back to the samsara. That has been synchronized, that has been harmonized, that has been established, that has been affirmed and it has been declared. That's what he says. Sarvam samanchasam. Sarvam. All of them. Look at the words and everything. Vasudeva sarvamidi. There he says that one. So Bhagavan is the sarvam. You have to get that. Now when you say Dhyoyadidi sarvam samanchasam. Anything you bring. Okay. So, yeah, when you bring the Vedas and the Upanishads and Alvar Spasuram, any of them you bring, All of them are very nicely correlated here. Sarvam samanchasa means it fits properly. It is the right way. It is a good conclusion. It is the only verdict. That is what he says. So, idi sutrabhyasaga sastra parisamabdim deyo dayadi idi sarvam samanchasam. That is the final verdict. Given that one, any place you go, all of them coming to the conclusion, Sriman Narayana is the supreme leader. He is the one who can give you the moksham. He is the one Jagatkarana Tattvam. And he is the one you have to go as a means and as a palan. When he gives that moksham, you will not come back over here. This is the right interpretation of any of the sastras you take. This is how it has to be explained. When you explain this one, everything is synchronized. Everything is concurring correctly. That is the best way to explain in an optimized fashion, he says. One more thing we take it. It is not in the Śrībhāṣyam. But the Alvar says, Swami, you said when you go there, he will not come back. One, Bhagavan will not send. Two, you will not come back. What about other people? And that one is very nicely, he says, Periyalvar Thirumuli. Vayinal namo narana vendre mattagattidai kaigalai koopi poyinal pinnai iddisaikkum endrum pinai kodikkilum poga vattare. Periyalvar's passages are amazing. Amazing, he says. Vayinal, you have to tell that one. When he says, namo narana vendre, very beautiful. Om namo narayana aya. That is a mantra. And you take the pranavam and you take the ayapadam, you knock it off, you get namo narana. That is basically nama ucharanam. Whether you tell the mantram om namo narayana aya or nama ucharanam namo narana, the palan is exactly the same. In the Swami Desigan says in the mulamantra adhikaram, in the ragasetra saram. So, vayinal namo narana vendru, that means anybody can tell that one. So, he is coming into the prabhatti margam, he is telling. Vayinal namo narana vendru, you have to do the ucharanam. Either you tell that one or the acharya tell that one. Either it is a ukti nishtai or a acharya nishtai. Vayinal namo narana vendru, mattagattidai kaigalai koopi. Mattagattidai means uchi. Kaigalai koopi, anjali, how you have to do, above your head you have to put the two hands. Anjali mudrai, above your head you are telling, please take me through the murdhanyanadi. That is why thalagalakku mela kaiyu koopana, highest level from the whole body, whatever I have below that anjali mudrai is doing the sharanagadi to you. Mattagattidai kaigalai koopi, anjali, anjali vaibhavam, very beautifully Alavandar Swami has done, Desiyan has done, Children Agasyam on that one. Very nice. Anjali, am jalayadi idi anjalihi. When you do this two hands putting together and doing this namaskaram kind of namaste, namaha te, I am a servant to you. When you say like that one, poyinal, when you do that one, when you go to the paramapadam, poyinal, when you die, maranam aanal vaiyundam podukkum piran, maranam aanal, same thing, poyinal, paramapadam poi chendal, when you do, pinnai, piragu, afterwards, pinai kodikkilum means, when you go over there, some of the nityas and muktas are saying there, they are already there. Let's say Anantan, Garudan, Vitsaksena, all the gatekeepers, so Dwarabalaga, somebody says, you know, this guy has come over here recently, send him down there, just go for 10 years, just go for 2-3 janmas, let him go and come back. I give the guarantee, sir, he will come back. So, I'll give you this one. Uttaravadam, that is what? Pinegudakilam, guarantee. I'll give the bail. Let him go over there. So, when he says, Pinegudakilam, in some of the Acharya's explanation, they say, even Sri Mahalakshmi tells like that one. Because Periyalvar previously told, Tannadiya tirattagat தாமரையாளாகிலும் சிதகுரைக்கு மேல் என்னடியாரது செய்யார் செய்தாரே நன்று செய்தார் என்பர் போலும் ப்ரீவியஸ்லி ஹஸ் டோல்ட் ஸோ டோன்ட் கிவ் இம் தி மோக்ஷம் ஐ ஹவ் ரெக்கமெண்டட் ஹிம் பிகாஸ் ஹி ஹஸ் டன் தி புருஷகார பிரபத்தி நவு லுக்கிங் அட் இஸ் புக் ஆல் தி அசட்ஸ் அண்ட் லயபிலிட்டிஸ் இஸ் காட் ஸோ மெனி நெகட்டிவ் திங்ஸ் ஐ நெவர் லுக் தட் ஒன் ப்ரீவியஸ்லி நோ நோ கேன்சல் தட் ஒன் டேக் இட் வாபஸ் டேக் இஸ் மோக்ஷம் பகவான் சேஸ் தன்னடியா திரத்தகத்து தாமரையாளாகும் தன்னடியா திரகத்தக ஆன் தி அக்கௌண்ட் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் ஓன் அடியார்ஸ் தாமரையாள் ஸ்ரீ மகாலட்சுமி சிதகு உரைக்குமேல் ஷீ ஃபைன்ஸ் ஃபால்ட் ஆன் தம் தென் பகவான் சேஸ் என்னடியார் அது செய்யார் என்னடியார் அது செய்யார் மை டிவோட்டிஸ் வில் நாட் டூ லக்ஷ்மி மேபி யுவர் டிவோட்டிஸ் பகவான் சேஸ் என்னடியார் அது செய்யார் வெரி பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி ஆச்சாரிய சேஸ் என்னடி யார் செய்தார் இஸ் சேயிங் ஒன் மோர் லெவல் ஹையர் இஸ் ஷோயிங் தட் ஒன் ஆஸ் அ புருஷன் என்னடி இஸ் காலிங் சேயிங் யார் செய்தார் ஹூ டிட் திஸ் ஒன் மை டிவோட்டிஸ் வில் நாட் டூ தட் ஒன் ஸோ வென் ஹி ஹஸ் டோல்டு தட் ஒன் அண்ட் தி உபாயம் பார்ட் ஆஃப் தட் ஒன் வென் பகவான் ஹஸ் அக்செப்டட் நவ் ஹியர் ஈவன் இன் மோக்ஷம் பிணை கொடுக்கிலும் தட்ஸ் வாட் இட் இஸ் சேஸ் guaranteed when they are given the pond that one I will do this you will come back it doesn't matter who did that one but acharyas explain it could be nitya suris it could be different muktas over there or it could be pirati there even endrum any time oru kaalum poga vattar he will not send them back so very beautifully alvar says over here வாயினால் நமோ நாரணா என்று மத்தகத்திடை கைகளை கூப்பி போயினால் பின்னை இத்திசைக்கும் என்றும் பிணை கொடுக்கிலும் போக ஒட்டாரே வெரி பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி சேஸ் தட்ஸ் வை லைக் தி ஆழ்வார் வி ஹவ் டேக்கன் தட் ஒன் பகவான் வில் நாட் சென்ட் யூ வில் நாட் கம் அண்ட் நோபடி வில் டூ தட் வே ஈவன் இஃப் ஈ ட்ரைஸ் டு சே சம்திங் தே மே நாட் ஹவ் பவர் But that doesn't stop them. They can tell. But when they tell, still he will not listen. You said, Ottar Mikara Ilaya Yamamiya, that's okay. But these people can make a request. They can ask. They can plead. Still he will not do that one. So, by any means, whether it's by Bhagavan or you or by others, he will not come back. So, when you go to the mokshram, that is only one way. You will never come back to this kind of a net, whatever we are having called samsaram. That completes the 545th sutra, 156th adhigarana, jagat vyabhara varja adhigaranam, completion of the 4th pādam, mukti pādam, 4th adhyayam, paladhyayam. Emperumana finally ends with this, ஸ்ரீ பகவத் ராமானுஜ விரச்சிதே ஹீ ஹிம்செல்ஃப் புட்ஸ் இன் டு தட் ஒன் பகவத் ராமானுஜ தட் மீன்ஸ் ஐ டென்ட் ரைட் திஸ் ஒன் பகவான் ஹஸ் மேட் திஸ் ஒன் தட் இஸ் ஸோ ஹி ஹஸ் கிவன் த டைட்டில் பகவத் ராமானுஜ ஹீ ஹிம்செல்ஃப் ஹஸ் ரிட்டன் பகவத் ராமானுஜ விரச்சிதே சாரீரக மீமாம்சா பாஷ்யே சதுர்த்தஸ்யாத்யாயஸ்ய சதுர்த்த பாதஹ சமாப்த சாத்யாய சாஸ்திரம் ச பரிசமாப்தம் திஸ் இஸ் ஒன் சாரீரக மீமாம்ச பாஷ்யா விசிஷ்டாத்வைத சித்தாந்தம் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் தி ஃபோர் அத்தியாயா ஈச் ஒன் ஹஸ் காட் ஃபோர் பாதம் டோட்டலி 16 பாதம் ஆஃப் தம் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் இஸ் நவ் எண்டிங் சாஸ்திரம் பரிசமாப்தம் The sastram, what we are learning from this one, is completed in a nice way, in a sacred, holy way, in a nice, serene, pleasing way it is ended. Sri Bhagavade Bhashyakaraya Namaha, Srimade Nigamanta Mahadeshikaya Namaha. That ends with that. Again, add one more here. Swami Desikan has done the Adhigarna Saravali. அதிகன சாராவளி சம்திங் லைக் அபவுட் 560 ஸ்லோகாஸ் ஆர் சிக்ஸ் ஐ டோன்ட் ரிமெம்பர் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி ஆல்மோஸ்ட் 500+ ஸ்லோகாஸ் ஆர் தேர் இந்த அதிகன சாராவளி The places where you get confused on the Śrībhāṣyam, he explains more. We take one of the place where the 16 pādams of the Śrībhāṣyam is very beautifully explained with the 16 phrases. Okay, he has done in Tamil also in one of the prabandham. So here, 4 adhyayas are there. Samanvaya adhyayam, that is the first adhyayam. Every single word in the Shastram goes and ends with Bhagavan Sriman Narayana only. The first padam, Shrestha, that is the word Swami Desian uses in the Adhirana Saravali. Shrestha means is the creator, sustainer, destroyer, is the Jagajanmadi Karanam. Sriman Narayana, you put that on at the top. All the 16 adhyayams talking to him and mentioning about him. Shrestha 1-1, Shrestha 1-2, first adhyayam, second padam, Dehi. He has got both sentient and non-sentient, Chetana, Achetana Vastu, as is Deham, as is Shariram. Shrestha Dehi Swanishta, 1-3 is Swanishta. I understand. He is supporting everybody. But who is supporting him? When you ask that one, he is the supreme. He is the supporter, controller, say she, owner of everything of the universe, including himself. Unparalleled, unsurpassed. No one needs to support him. He is the supporter of himself. Swanishta. Next one, 1-4, Niravadi Mahima, is infinite with all the Trikalyana Gunas that establishes him the supremacy. So that is the Samanvaya Adhyayam. In the second Adhyayam, Avirodha Adhyayam, whatever we told in the Samanvayam, everything goes back and correlates to Bhagavan Sriman Narayana, you cannot refuse that one. Okay? So we say that one in the office, they put one. Rule number one, I am the boss. Rule number two, if you have any doubt, go back to the rule number one. That is what it is. Avirodha Adhyayam, Abhastapada. Abhastapada means the Bhagavan established in the first chapter, first Adhyaya, Samanvaya Adhyaya, cannot be rejected, cannot be refuted, cannot be discarded by any other philosophy. Sankhya, Yoga, Charvaka, Vaiseshika, Buddha, Jaina, Pashupada, etc., etc. None of them we can refute, he says that. Sridhapta, 2-2. Sridhapta means those who go to the Bhagavan and they feel they are dependent on him, they surrender to him. He is the one who is he. He is the author of the Pancharatragamam. What is Pancharatragamam? Ancharatragamam is Bhagavan told through his own mouth. It's not like Veda. Vedas apaurusheyam. Nobody has done. Here Bhagavan says, just like the Gita, it comes through Krishna's mouth. Here Bhagavan has told Pancharatragama Sastram. That is the only thing that has been approved in the Brahma Sutram by Bhadarayana. So Pancharatragama, which is equivalent to, he says, because this is done by the Bhagavan with all correlating to the other Vedas, we can think this is equivalent to the Vedas, in accordance to the Vedas, he said that one. So that Bhagavan, when you surrender to him, all the Shruti, Smriti, Idigasa, Purana, Agama Sastra, when you say that one, all of them correlates only to him. Kaatma, when you say that one, Bhagavan Narayana is the creator of everything. He is the creator of the all this Leela Vibhuti, including the Jivatma. When he says, he creator of the Jivatma, what any 2-4 comes. How can you create Jivatma? That is where it says, Dehendriyad Deha Uchita Janakrita. He is a creator of the body, indriyams and everything. So the Atma He inserts in that one, Anupravesham. He also comes and sits that one. The kind of things what we have, Shariram and Atma put together, He is one creates all of them. How does He create that? Based on your account ledger. In the account ledger is Anadigala Karma. So you are having that one. Based on that one, He picks a box of this. Sanjidam, Prarabdam, Agami, and all of them. Sanjidam, He pulls that one. That is called, becomes the Prarabdam. And He gives for several Janmas. So, that is the four padams in the Avirodha Adhyayam. Now going to the Sadhana Adhyayam, that is the third one. Samsrudau Tantravahi. When He says, Sriman Narayana is the controller of the entire universe. He is the controller, whether it is action or inaction. Inaction itself is an action. You have to be quiet. Being quiet itself is an action. Being not doing anything is a doing, because you are preventing something to do that itself. Samsrudau Tantravahi, when He says that, Bhagavan Sriman Narayana is the controller of the entire universe, actions and inactions. Nirdoshatvadi Ramyo, Bhagavan has got any dosham, no dosham at all. Ubaya Linga Adhikaranam, when you go over there, He is identified by two of them. The identifiers, namely, He is one with infinite Trikalyana Gunas. Agaleheya Pratyaniga Kalyana Gunaiga Dana. When you say no negative things, all good things of that. That is it. Nirdoshatvadi Ramyo. Ramyaha is very beautiful to enjoy. That kind of a quality He has got. Third one, 3-3 in the Sadhanadhyayam, third padam, Bahu Bhajana Padam. Sriman Narayana is the ultimate goal for all the Bhakti Yoga Brahma Vidyas mentioned in the Upanishad. He alone is meditated who wants to get out of this samsaram. Out of 31 Brahma Vidyas, two of them belongs to somebody. Or Saturday, Sunday, you belong to tell somebody. Or in this place, you talk about. No. Uniquely, all the time, only to Him. Nothing else. Bahu Bhajana Padam, when He says that one. Next one, 3-4. Swarga Karma Prasadaya. Why I am not thinking about Bhagavan? Why did I do Prabhati last week? Why I didn't do 20 years back? Everything is based on your karma. Bhagavan gives the palan based on that. Swa arha karma prasada. So based on what you have done, He gives the results and the rewards and punishment based on your karma. He alone grants. Okay? Maybe prati, maybe the influence. He alone. So, Purushartha, when you say Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksham, Aram, Purul, Inbam, Vidu, all of them. So, it is not Moksham alone He gives. Something else you go to the other gods. No, it is not. All of them He gives that one. Okay. So, that is the third Adhyaya, Sadhana Adhyaya, four Padams. Next, coming to the Phalādhyāya, 4-1, Pāpachitu. He is the only one who can destroy the obstacles. What is the obstacles we have? Punyam and Pavam are the vilangu, kai vilangu bole. Swami Desikan says, both of them like the handcuff. One is the iron handcuff, the other one is a golden handcuff. Pavam will give you punishment, Punyam will give you luxury, you will forget about Bhagavan. So, both of them is an obstacle for you. So, who practices bhakti or prabhati, that has to be removed and purifies them, makes them good, makes them qualified to get the moksham, make you to be eligible for the bhakti yogya, bhakti yogyan and prabhati yogyam. So, those are the things in the Ragasatra Saram at the beginning of the chapters, it would be there. 4-2, once you pabajiti, all the pavas are removed, now you are ready. Brahmanadi kadigrithi. Brahmanadi gadikrithi. So, He makes the jivatma separate that atma and body inside, make a sukshma shariram inside the atma passes through, okay, murdanyanadi, so brahmanadi, uchinadi. So after the pava and punya are removed, then he does that one brahmanadi gadikrithu 4-3 adivahan. After that one, you have to go through the archiradi margam as guided by the Adivahi Asul of them over there. Archis Agni is in front of them. Amanavan is going to be the monitor. He is doing all of them. Vigasa all of them. That is 4-3. 4-4 finally coming to Samyadascha Atravedya. He is making equivalent to him. Equivalent to him, we have to be very careful. Okay. So, he is going to give Saulokya, Sarubhya, Samibhya, Sayujya. Saulogya, Jeevan goes into the Lokam, that is Paramapadam, Vaikuntha Lokam, where Bhagavan is there, Saulogya. Sarubhya, after the Apsarastris are coming, each one of them, 500 Apsarastris, hundreds of them, they give you different kinds of things. Kudare Vellam Sir Govinda, in that pasuram we have seen. And so when they give all of them, you get the Divyamana Trimeni after the Amanavan's Parisam. You do that one, that Sarubhya. Samibhya, they take you, walk you through all the great roads over there, going into the Tirumamani Mandapam, where Bhagavan is sitting over there in the court. Sitting there, you are going Samibhya, you are getting closer to him. Sayujya. So Bhagavan takes the Jivatma, put it on his lap and says, Kosi is asking, Aham Brahmasmi. When you say that one, Sayujyam. Okay, that is going to be the ultimate bliss you're going to be. Bhagavan, I have heard all these things with so many different kind of pramanas. I never knew. Today, I understand what you are. I am the Shariram for you. Aham Brahmasmi. You are the Atma. I am the Shariram. I am realizing here today. Bhagavan patted in your back and he says, you can stay here and do Kaingaryam infinitely. That is what finally is going to happen. That is called Sayujyam. So, Desiyan very beautifully explaining all of them. In the 16, in a single sloka, all the 16 padams very nicely. So, we have not seen all the different adhyayam, all the padams are, but at least we have seen after the later part of third one and fourth of them, we have seen the whole thing because that is the rewards. So, we have to be enjoying Nisamsega Sugamaswa. As Embermanar says in the Gadhyam, how can you be Sugamaswa unless you understand? Look at the video picture of Hawaii, where are we going to go? This is the house, this is the place, this is how we are going to enjoy. We have to be keep on thinking about that one. So, Sriman Narayana is the Parabrahma Bhudam. That is what finally Desiyan says in the Adhigana Saravali, concurring with the Embermanar, Parabrahma Bhudam. When you say Brahmam, that is Sriman Narayana, not Narayana, Sri Sambandham, okay, Lakshmi Narayanan, and that is what we understand from the Sariraga Sastram. When we understand when the Brahma Sutram, as Badarayana has written in all of them, 545 sutras, 156 adhigaranams, 4 adhyayams, each adhyayam 4 padam, what we understand, only one thing we understand. Vasudeva Sarvamidi, that is what he said there. Here he says, he is the Parabrahmam. Everything ends with him. He is everything. Okay. The meaning of the entire Vedas is Vasudeva Sarvam. That is what Swami Desigan in the Adhyana Saravali, he concludes on that one. So, with that one, we are concluding the Śrībhāṣyam, the fourth chapter, fourth adhyaya. So, we took about 81 lectures on this one. Totally here and there, we saw some other things. But a conclusion of one doesn't mean it's over. We'll pick up in a different place, a different time, different things we'll talk. But in a sequentially, what we are seeing, the fourth adhyayam, we have completed over here. Again, wants to talk a little more on this Bhagavad Gita, seventh chapter. Vasudeva Sarvam, how does it come? That jnanam. So, we'll pick it up along with this Paripurna Brahmanu Bhavam. When we talk about the Ragasatra Saram, we completed the Tiruvaimuri, we completed the Śrībhāṣyam, then we go into this Ragasatra Saram, we'll talk over there. and a couple of lectures or a few lectures on that one. That will give you a good idea what do you mean by Vasudeva Sarvam. So that is the essence of our sampradayam. Bhagavan is everything. That is what we have to understand. You are nothing but a tool. Swamin, Swasesham, Swavasam, Swabharadvena, Nirbharam, Swadatta, Swadiya, Swardham, Swasmin. As we say, Swami Desiyan in the Nyasa Dasham, Bhagavan is everything. Vasudeva Sarvam. That is the essence of Bhagavad Gita. That is the essence of all the Shastras what we have. I then conclude here. Kavidharkeya Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Simade Venkadesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Simade Nekhamanta Maha Deshigaya Namaha.